You owe you an explanation. You need to look at yourself in the mirror and say, why are you only giving 50%? What's wrong with you? You need to put yourself on punishment. You need to tell you, no more TV, no more snacks, no more desserts, no more, no, we working out now. No more alcohol, not right now. No, I can't handle it right now. You need to tell you that you owe you something. You've never looked at yourself in the mirror and said, you let you down. Until you get to that point, you let you down. You're not brave enough. You want to put it on somebody else. The reason why I'm not successful is because of my boss. Have you ever looked at yourself in the mirror and said, I'm not getting up on time. I'm not going to work on time. I'm not putting in 120% when I'm at work. I let me down. What changed? I changed. And I stopped being a victim. I stopped saying, I've got to wait for good things to happen to me. And I said, I'm going to grind. I'm going to fight. I'm going to work. I'm going to press toward. I'm going to learn. I'm going to do everything in my power. Every single day, I'm going to do everything in my power to become a victor and not a victim. What do you want in your marriage? What do you want with your son and your daughter? What do you want in your health? What do you want financially? Like, how much money do you want to make a year? What do you want to drive? How do you want to live? Stop just waking up like an accident. What do you want? And then once you find out what you want, spend the rest of your natural life waking up and going after it. There is no excuse for not living up to your fullest potential. No excuse. I don't believe in the word procrastination. Like, I don't really believe in that word. I told a young lady in Australia who told me she was a procrastinator. I said, look, if I told you to meet me here tomorrow at 5 a.m. and I'm gonna give you $3 million, where would you be? She said, I'll be right there at 4:59, ready to get that $3 million. And I said, so there's no such thing as procrastination. What it is it's not important to you, right? It's not meaning for you, to you. It's not something that's urgent to you. And when something is not urgent, you put it off. But if it's not meaningful to you, if it's not important to you, then you're not gonna make it a priority. So what you have to do is find out, how can you make it meaningful? How can you make it purposeful? How can you make it stick? And when you can find that out, I promise you, you'll get up early, you'll get there first, and you'll do whatever it takes to make that goal a reality. So for me, no such thing as procrastination. It's a such thing as it's not a priority to you.
There's a 5-second window between the instincts, the shoulds, the urges, the inner wisdom, the things that can change your life if you listen to it. Got a 5-second window from the moment you feel that instinct to move. And if you don't, your brain is actually designed to kill it. 5 seconds is all you have. The second you hesitate, it's actually, and you feel yourself hesitating, that is a moment of huge power, because what's happened is you've just started to pull back from something that you need to lean into. And if you count backwards, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and this is the neuroscience behind why this stupid little trick works, counting is an action. Counting backwards requires focus. It's also not a habit for you yet. So when you feel yourself hesitate, you're triggering your mind that something's up. Your mind now goes into a cognitive bias called the spotlight effect. It magnifies whatever it was that you hesitated doing. Like, all of a sudden you're like, hey, I don't feel like it. Like, I don't know, maybe I'll do it later. And your mind is doing it because your mind's trying to protect you. Hesitation signals a red flag to your mind that something's up. Just that small hesitation, it's a habit that we all have. Should you hesitate if you're getting a tattoo? Yes. Should you hesitate if you're gambling? Yes. Should you hesitate if you are signing a legal document? Yes. You need your prefrontal cortex for those things. You need to interrupt it, make a decision. Should you hesitate on making a phone call? No. Should you hesitate on speaking up in a meeting? No. Should you hesitate when you feel yourself starting to procrastinate and you know you got work that you should get done? No, you shouldn't hesitate at all. Should you hesitate in saying the thing that you really feel in your heart? No, you shouldn't. Should you hesitate and edit yourself when you're talking? No, you shouldn't. But we've all trained ourselves to. So it's actually this habit of hesitating. You start catching yourself. It's a huge moment of power because you have a decision to make and you got to make it in the next 5 seconds. Are you going to go on autopilot and get trapped in your mind? Or are you going to 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and awaken your prefrontal cortex and drive forward?
Everything matters. If you take any situation and just take the word only and take the word just out of it, it changes the whole phrase. It's just a game. It's a game. It's only a job. If you feel like this isn't only a job, before this interview is up, I advise you to get up and leave right now. Because there's somebody else who will fill this seat up and take that job and turn it into a career. Be careful of those words, trap words. I'm just going to smoke one cigarette. That shows you their preparation from a mental standpoint of how weak they really are. There's a lot of people that are just a something. There's very few people that are the something, okay? So when people introduce myself as a trainer, I'm like, no, I'm not a trainer, I'm the trainer. It's a huge difference.
So self-doubt, worry, procrastination, overthinking, analysis paralysis, fear, those are all thinking patterns that are habits. One of the most important things that I want people to understand is that you're actually not a worrier. You have a habit of worrying. Big difference. You're not a procrastinator. You have a habit of procrastinating. Big difference. Every one of those behavior patterns and thinking patterns can actually be interrupted and replaced using science. You can use a simple trick. The moment you feel yourself hesitate, the moment you've got one of those moments where you know that you need to, this is that moment that Lewis talks to you about where you got to step outside of your comfort zone and you've got to lean into your passion and you've got to really take some risks and you got to feel the fear and you got to do it anyway. That's the moment where you just woke up and now you got a decision to make. Are you going to drift back into the habits or are you going to awaken your prefrontal cortex and drive forward and focus and do something new? Do you feel like making that cold call? No, you don't. Do you feel like doing that third set of reps? No, you don't. Do you feel like having that hard conversation? No, you don't. Do you feel like ending this relationship, whether it's in business or in your life, that is sucking you dry? No, you don't. We make decisions based on our feelings, and that is robbing you of joy and opportunity. And it is blinding you from the fact that how you change your life is 1 5-second decision at a time, one push at a time. And if you accept the fact that you may never feel ready and you may never feel motivated and you may never feel confident, you may never feel courageous, and that's okay, but you can still push yourself forward. What happens over time is as you start to see yourself becoming the person that takes action, if you start to see yourself becoming the kind of person that speaks even though your voice is shaking, you're the kind of person that has a bias toward moving instead of a bias toward thinking, guess what happens? You build the skill of confidence and courage. It's working for people around the world. And, you know, in the book, it took me 3 years to write it. It's all the science behind the rule. Yeah. It's got more than 150 social media posts in it. So you see stories from around the world of people using it to end procrastination, to build confidence, to deepen their relationships, to launch businesses.
My true feeling is this: no matter who you are, no matter what age you are, no matter the time in your life, if you have a dream and you have the drive, you can make anything happen.
When you're chasing your dream and when you're working hard, chasing something you love, and it just happens. You can't really notice it. You know, even still to this day, I'm in an amazing position in my life, but I'm still working like I'm not. I'm still working like I'm not in this position. Just keep pushing, keep working hard.
You had to dream that you could be something in life and do something in life. If you don't dream it, you can't become it.
I think my imagination has always kept me going. You know what I mean? It's like, you know, just imagine myself collecting awards. Just imagine myself, you know what I mean, getting big parts. Imagine myself working with the greatest actors. My imagination was the one, like, you know what I mean? Like, you know when you're not overthinking, you're just kind of like, yeah, man, I see myself driving that car. Like, and I get that. You know what I mean? That's part of my inner magic, is that actually, if I can see myself doing it, I could probably do it.
If you really have a drive and you really put your heart and soul into something, you can really make anything happen. I'm a true believer in that.
I realized that to have the level of success that I want to have, it's difficult to spread it out and do multiple things. You know, it's in order to be world class, and I made a decision, I want to be world class. It takes such a desperate, obsessive focus to excel on the level that I want to make movies. You really got to focus with all of your fiber and all of your heart and all of your creativity.
I've never met a person who was not successful that didn't have a great amount of self-discipline within their life. Self-discipline and being able to perform and being able to keep your life on schedule and being able to keep commitments and promises and meet deadlines is essential to success. None of us can afford to have a life that is controlled by someone else, or a life that is basically controlled by our emotions. There are two kinds of people. There's the type of person who says, I'm going to wait till I feel like it before I do it. And then there's a person who says, I've got to do it so that I feel like it. One will never get anything done because they're still waiting to feel the moment to move. And the other person says, no, I need to move, and then I will begin to feel the moment. Sonia, self-discipline is essential in your life and in my life if we're going to get things done.
If you get up and you just have no discipline whatsoever, you get no value of anything. Your diets don't work when you don't do them. Exercise doesn't work when you don't do them. But most of the people have some experiences that they want to shift. And once you shift those things, your whole life changes. But life is constant growth. My life isn't here because I went to one seminar one time and now my life is fit for life. I work out, I train my mind, I train my body, and it becomes a lifestyle.
A lot of you will block your own success because you're fearful of what's going to happen. Because the comfort zone is here. Make a great living. My bills are paid. Everything is great. Oh, I'm scared to change. So you block your own growth. So you have to now say to yourself, hey, once you get the tools, once you've done your homework, then you can start making a move to say, okay, hey, I can be a businesswoman, a businessman, and start my own thing. But you gotta believe in yourself first.
You have to actually show up every day and inch yourself forward toward these dreams. And not only show up every day and once in a while inch yourself, I mean every day, you have to actually take an action that moves you forward. Not just research, not just thinking. Look, the power of intention is great, but without any initiative, it's dead, right? A dream is great, but without any movement, it's dead. You have to be moving towards every day.
You want to be totally focused. You can't take your eye off the ball.
You cannot lose by taking action. You can only lose by not taking action. And if you delay taking action repeatedly over and over again, you develop the habit of never taking action. You get to develop the habit of procrastinating and holding back and so on.
Take action. So many people talk about doing something or say, what if? They don't actually get up and do it. Taking action is really, really important.
My advice is just to focus on each day. And you know, you have a plan in place of how you want to improve and how you want to get better. And you stick to that plan and trust the fact that, you know, every day that you stick to the plan, it'll get you to your end result.
The key to being successful is to work harder than other people. Because everybody wants success. Everybody wants a Lamborghini. Everybody wants freedom. But what are you willing to do to get there?
So much of success is seeing yourself as victorious. You have to see yourself. You have to really believe in yourself. And sometimes it's hard. You know, you've had failures, you've had weaknesses, you've had other things. You have to see yourself as a one-man band. Don't rely too much on other people because they'll let you down. You have to see yourself as victorious.
Anything and everything can be done if you can visualize it, if you believe in yourself.
To be a winner, you have to think like a winner. If you don't think like a winner, it's just never going to happen.
You're going to find the naysayers in every turn that you make. Don't listen. Just visualize your goal, know exactly where you want to go. Trust yourself. Get out there and work like hell and break some of the rules and never, ever be afraid of failure.
The time is now. The time is now to express and for people to believe in themselves. The time is now for it to be okay to be great.
When you look at the accomplishments of accomplished people, and you say, boy, that must have been really hard. You know, when you look at something that looks hard, that was probably easy. And conversely, when you look at something that looks easy, that was probably hard. And so you're never gonna know which is which until you actually go and do it. So just go and do it, try, learn from it. You'll fail at some things. That's a learning experience that you need so that you can take that on to the next experience. Don't let people who you may respect and who you believe know what they're talking about, don't let them tell you it can't be done. Because often they will tell you it can't be done. It's just because they don't have the courage to try it.
The bridge between reality and a dream is work. And I always, in moments of despair and doubt and dark days, focus on the work. I show up and I work and I work and I work and I work.
You'll never be the best looking, you'll never be the tallest, most talented, most capable, you'll never have the most money. There will always be someone who's better at whatever you're doing than you are. But you can always be the hardest working person in the room. And I think the hardest working person will always win.
Hard work pays. I put in a hell of a lot of work all throughout this build-up in the fight. I pumped out more content than anybody, more content than Fox, more content than ESPN, more content than BT Sport, more content than everybody on the Mac Live on my own channels. You know what I mean? I'm a workhorse from all angles, not just in the gym. I'm building this media empire now myself, and we pumped out the content. I'm very proud of how it went. We consistently, daily movies I was releasing, you know, from like a month ago, every single day. You know what I mean? Nobody's doing that. So I'm very proud of it, and I'm very, like, the work pays, hard work pays.
I don't think there's any magic in being successful. And I'm not talking about making $1 million or $1 billion. I'm just talking about being successful. I don't think there's any magic. You gotta work hard. Yeah. You gotta respect the people around you, and you just gotta go. I've never met a successful person that doesn't work hard.
In life, you should only ever be doing one of two things, and that is,
you know, to be great, I think you have to fight. And I very much think that my success is a product of some level of skill, but I do think I win because I outwork people. I really do believe that. I do believe that 100%.
I realize that information changes situations. So I'd rather buy a book than buy a house. Because if I buy a book, I can buy several homes. You can take all my money out the bank. It might hit me, ooh. But if you take the knowledge out of my head and take the experiences that I have, I'm broke, I'm nothing. The problem with most people is that you're not obsessed with improvement.
Every day, work harder on yourself than anything else. Because if you become more intelligent, more valuable, more skilled, you can add more value to other people. All you have to focus on in your life is find a way to add more value than anybody else does, and you'll never have to worry about anything. Be the person that does more for others, and life will just be anything you want out of it, really is what it is.
I'm here, all of my dreams and aspirations are here, and the only thing in between these two is a bunch of work. So tackling that work is a way of moving this needle.
So listen to me, there are those of you who said, I wanna be a millionaire, I wanna be the best at this company, right? But your value system says you believe in sleep more than you believe in grinding. Your value system says you are a consumer and not a producer. That you're spending more money than you're making. Why? Because you're a consumer, but you're reading all the books and you're saying everything the books are saying. But those books are not in alignment with your values. And if you're gonna go to the next level, your values are gonna have to change.
Life is like this super temporary, mega fragile thing.
You only get like a nugget of time to really pursue the things you care about.
We have to understand what we're good and bad at, and you have to let go of what you're bad at. You have to. If you're naturally bad at singing like I am, you shouldn't put your career and your life in a position to become a professional singer. It's a bad idea.
In life, you should only ever be doing one of two things, and that is figuring out what you're most passionate about, like finding your dreams in life. And then two, realizing those passions, realizing those dreams.
When you're not clear on what you want, like you get up whenever you feel like it, you don't have no drive, you don't have no passion. And so when people ask me, E, where your passion come from? Where your drive come from? I know what I want. I'm talking about knowing what you want, because when you know what you want, that's where the drive comes from. That's where the passion comes from.
Keep yourself extremely busy. As long as you're doing something, you will find your path. It's when you get lazy that everything becomes skewed, everything becomes gray or foggy.
Your life comes down to your decisions, and if you change your decisions, you will change everything.
I think life is substantiated by whatever impact or whatever contribution you can make while you're alive. The finish line's the same for everyone. We're all ending up in the same place, but while we're here, what contribution can you make? Life shrinks and life expands in direct proportion to your willingness to assume risk. The most dangerous thing you can do in your career, the most dangerous thing you can do in life is play it safe.
If you want to affect the world, you have to change yourself first. Everybody tries to go out and change the world by changing other people and other things. But the real way to do it is by changing yourself. And sometimes making those really uncomfortable choices to go up against everyone in your life that you look up to and take that risk.
When I visit students, I also tell them that the greatest risk they take is not taking one, which, by the way, Miss Martinez taught me that. And I use it to this day. Anytime I feel that, should I feel nervous like I feel right now, I take the risk. And for all the students, for all the teachers, and for all the educators here, we have to take risk. If we don't take that risk, I go back to it. It's the biggest risk that we take.
It's not that we have a short time to live, but that we waste a lot of it.
Everybody has time. Stop watching fucking Lost. If you want this, if you want bling bling, if you want to buy the jets, if you want to do work.